ready for kickoff. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's out to the 30. Brought down at the 32-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. Linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. First down. Tackle made at about the 45. The halfback just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of one.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. And he's taken down at the 29-yard line.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
This will make it a field goal game. He gets it up, and he got it. To kick this one away. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The Rams have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 50. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy is amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
Tight left, He's at the 40. Knocked out of bounds at about the 33-yard line.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
From the 33-yard line, first down. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper, a loss of one.
That'll bring up second and 11.
There's a strike complete, and he shoved out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 23. Archer off the right side. Nice run to the outside.
Boy, I thought he was going to pick it up. That was a solid effort, but the defense held him back.
Pickup. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Got some open field. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. So another run and another first down.
It's time for the defense to buckle down. They need to start hitting the gaps and getting into the backfield.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And they're in. Touchdown. And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 71-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
The score now, 7-3. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kicker. He'll return it from the one. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Brought down around the 20-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down at the 37-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. Complete, but out of bounds. Going to lose some ground. So at the end of one, the Rams lead 7-3. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well. That makes it fourth and one.
Salyer is the deep man awaiting the return. He really got hold of that one. They'll bring him down at the 31. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Throws it in a hurry. And he is drilled at the 40-yard line.
We got a change at the quarterback position. Got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Gets out to around the 38. Scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
From the 40-yard line, second down. They come out in an empty backfield. Scrambling around, and he's sacked. Defense really fired up.
These hits take a toll on a quarterback, physically and psychologically. The blockers have got to do a better job of taking care of him.
So that sack leaves them with some work to do. It's third down and 14. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Going long. Ball is loose. Fumble. They fall on it. He really wanted that ball, didn't he, Kirk?
Well, you can't teach hustle like that. The linebacker was determined to get the ball there, and he did.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
First and 10, all on the 11-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown.
He had the wherewithal to see the open space in front of him, and he just kept on zooming until he hit pay dirt.
He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the 4. He's tackled at the 27. So they're just about set to get the game going again. At the 37. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Yeah.
play fake. Halfback hauls it in past the marker. And down he goes at the 49-yard line.
Well, that's the beauty of running play action against zone coverage. In man, the defender has his eyes on the guy he's covering. But in zone, the defender's looking right at the quarterback. That's why that play action worked so well for a first down. They weren't sure if it was a run or a pass.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49. Hit before it could go anywhere. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. One away. So it's fourth down. What do you think they're going to do here?
At this point in the game, they might as well go for it. They won't lose much field position if they don't get it, and they only have a couple yards to go.
He makes it to the 38-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 23-yard line, it's first down. Bring him down for a loss on the play. There was just no daylight on that play, and the defensive lineman was the reason.
Well, that's one way to get involved in the game. Great stop in the backfield.
Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it.
That brings up third and 12.
Golden Eagles call a timeout. That's their second of the half. 10th play of the drive. Quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 11. This offense has really stalled on their last two trips to the red zone. He's going to try and scramble. They'll bring him down the 7-yard line. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened.
That makes it 6-6.
This is the 13th play of this drive. Quickly to the fullback. He's knocked out of bounds around the 1-yard line. First and goal, and they'd love to get into the end zone and make this a game again. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. He's got the corner. Touchdown! Score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
And converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
The Golden Eagles now with their quarterback down to an injury, and they've got to find a way to get back in this game and get their heads back in the game without their leader. And now he's got room to run. He'll take it himself.
This is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. He scrambled. Fumble. And they fall on the loose ball. He's tackled at the 47.
The Rams use their second timeout.
Steps up in the pocket. Throwing right. And it's caught. To the 10. And a huge touchdown play. That was some kind of catch and run by the halfback.
That was a mismatch that the offense took advantage of. He completely burned the defender for the score.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. Richardson has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. The Rams in front by 11.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out. Get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 25-yard line. They're 2 for 2 in finding the end zone on their last two drives. Let's see how they do here. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. The Rams saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. And he's got the freshman.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
17 yards. That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Wants to go long and does. Incomplete.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football and check it down or take off and run with it.
And they make the stop at about the 49.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36.
Crunch time, defense. Mark four.
Down. Nice run, and he's brought down. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's taken down at the 37-yard line.
Boy, this is just outstanding execution by the quarterback and the wide receiver. I mean, you look at that throw and you think, oh, my gosh, what are you doing? You're throwing that into coverage. But only he knows the confidence that he has in his wide receiver to have the ability to come down with the football for that first down. That's big time there between the quarterback and the wide receiver.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver.
Boy, that was a rocket. If the receiver didn't come down with it, the quarterback made sure nobody else was going to come down with it either.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's on the run. They'll make the sack.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. Brought down at the 40. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. Throws a bullet over the middle. Brought down at the 49.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of about two.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. They bring him down. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
The
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. He fields it at the 17. And down he goes at the 21. And he didn't get anything on that return.
Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Play action. Tackle made at about the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line. First down. He laterals the ball. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
Not much gained on that play because this safety did a wonderful job of getting up there and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
Taken down at the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. Throws and almost paid for it with a pick. So at the end of three, the Rams lead 21-10. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. So they're going to go for it here. The receiver's brought down before he can get there.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series. Make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
And down he goes at the 45. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And he's tackled at the 36. The 10, and they push him out around the 4-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. He's in there. Touchdown.
Let's go.
beautiful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
He makes the PAT. Richardson looks ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 25. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Tackle at the 43. From their own 43-yard line, it's first down. He's in trouble. And a quick throw. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line. Scrambling around. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. From the 48-yard line, it's second down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled right around the 38-yard line. He goes downtown. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. They'll go for two in this situation. Just under three to go in regulation. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. From the 41-yard line, second down. There's some daylight. And he hits him hard at the 31.
Sometimes when you've got speed, that's all you need. It's the one thing you just can't defend.
Nice run there. Archer gets 7 yards on the play. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Inside the 10, and they'll score. Tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
He wants it all. Missed him.
Sometimes when you throw it that hard, you can't control the accuracy all that well. He'll get it under control, though, in time.
Second and 10. Ball on the 25. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Gets it out quickly. Steps out of bounds at the 31-yard line.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up 34.
Roger, Roger. Mike, 4. Ready? Come on, let's go.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately.
Patrick's on the top of the perimeter.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Going long. Complete. He's knocked out of bounds at the 26-yard line. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful with their passing game. That time the quarterback threw it to a spot and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
Gets it out to his receiver and he can't hang on.
Number 41 was the intended receiver.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. He's looking for 6, and this will be caught. Touchdown.
These poor guys in the secondary look like they're still trying to catch up with him. He's gone in a heartbeat.
Converts the extra point. A nice 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
Tackle at the 40-yard line. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Just over a minute left. He makes it to the 38-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback. Just a minute remains in this football game. Golden Eagles using their third and final timeout. Up the middle for a nice game. The stop around the 32-yard line. Hawthorne's day comes to an end, not how he had planned it to go, but hey, team rallied around him beautifully.
Brad, I think you and I and everybody else expected a big day for him individually, and he didn't deliver. But most importantly, the team, as you said, was able to come up and kind of step in for his absence and win this football game.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.